Hello and welcome to this session of QnA Friday. On this channel, Automation Step by Step, I meet you every Friday and I take up one question asked by you and try to answer to the best of my knowledge and experience. So let's begin today's session of QnA Friday, and today we are taking up a question asked by Rehan, and Rehan says, I'm doing a sanity testing of my website. Is there an easy and quick way to find out all the spelling mistakes on my website? Rehan, thanks for asking this question. We are fortunate that today we have lots of tools and applications available that help us in doing a very quick sanity testing of our web applications, and some of them are open source and free as well. So today we are going to look at a very useful tool that will cater to your specific needs of finding out all the spelling mistakes on your website. So let us see how to do that. Let us go to our browser, and here I will type insights.com. So this is the site that we want to go to, and here is the website insights, make your websites better. Let us go here, and here is the homepage for insights tool, and here you can add any of your websites. So for example, I want to do a test on my website lifecharger.org. So I'll just copy this URL from here and provide this URL here. Of course, I do not want to retype HTTP and click on test. So here it will ask you to sign up or sign in. So in my case, I have already signed up, so I will use my email and password to log in. And once you log in, you will get this home page. Now here it is showing me some tests that I have already done. So in your case, this might be blank, so you can go here and say add website. And here you can add your website. So in my case, I am adding my website lifecharger.org. You can select the languages from here and then click on start testing. So it will take a couple of seconds and it will give you a very good summary report for the broken links and the spelling mistakes on your website. And you can see this real-time number, so it has found 5 spelling errors till now and it is in progress, and the spelling error count is increasing here. You can see that, the real-time data. Now once the test is done, it will show you the summary here. On this left menu, you can find summary, spelling and broken links. On the summary page, it will give you a summary of the count of spelling errors and the broken links found. And if you go down, it has listed down all the pages where it has found the errors, and it has also given us a count of the errors found per page. So if I can click on any page, it will go into the details of that page, and now you can see it has given us the details of all the errors found. I can click and it will go to that particular error. So in this case, you can see the word focused is spelled incorrectly and it can take us there. You can also click on this HTML, so it will take you to the HTML of the page where the error is, and this will be very handy if you want to send out a report to the development team or you want to fix it yourself. So you can see this is the error, and let me go again to the page, and now we have these options. So if you think that this is a correct issue, you can click on no and it will add it to your confirmed issues. If you think that this is not an issue, you can add this word to your dictionary so it will not be checked again. And then you have these other options to ignore for this page, lookup in Google and view in HTML. So for this particular issue, this is a potential issue, so I will click on no. And then again, this is also a misspelled word, again I will click on no. But this life charger, I think this is not correct as per the dictionary, but for my website I have deliberately used this word without any space, so I will click on yes. And you can see this is done. You can go to the next page directly from here, or you can go to the summary again. So I will just go to my summary again, and here in the summary you can go to the spellings. So I will just go to the spelling mistakes, and here it has given you a report of all the pages where it has found potential spelling mistakes, and here you can click on this drop down and you can retest this page, or if you want to exclude this page from the report, you can exclude this page. Also, you can see it has given us an entire list of the pages. You can click on view and directly go to that page. Also, if you want to look at the list of the words, you can click on the words and it will give us all the possible misspellings that it has found. And see, what we have confirmed is showing in red and the others are showing in potential. So we have confirmed these two issues. You can also export it as a report, so you can click on here or here to export it. So you can download the CSV, so it will download a CSV for you. Also, you can click on this export here, export button, and here it will ask you if you want to export all the test or only this test, and select A4 or letter and click on export. So it will export and then you can open the PDF. So you see, it has given us a very good PDF report which you can send it to your team. So this is how you can do a very quick and easy testing. I hope this session of Q&A Friday was very useful. In case you have any questions or comments or feedback, please do write them down in the comment section. I read all the comments and I will try to answer you as soon as I can. Also, if you have knowledge of other similar tools, please do mention them in the comments so that it will help our automation community. In case you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please do not forget to subscribe by hitting the subscribe button below. I will meet you in the next session of Q&A Friday. Thanks for watching.